It's happened, guys. In the first 3 years of me detailing, I have been accused of stealing out of a client's car. What is going on, you guys? It's your boy Bizman Cam here, and I am back with another video. Today's video, I got something a little crazy for y'all. I had a little situation recently where a client insinuated that I had maybe taken an item from them because it magically disappeared. So in this video, I'm pretty much just gonna be going through the story of what happened with this client, how I found them, how the situation went, like what the story was, and what I'm gonna do to prevent this from happening again, because out of the 3 years that I've been doing this, this is the first time that this has happened. I've had really nothing in place to prevent this. So now going forward, it's a lesson learned. And anyways, before this video begins, I need you guys to go ahead and smash that like button for your boy. Comment any video ideas you guys have down below. Subscribe, and any tools and products should be down in the description below if you guys are looking for any. So let's get right into the video. So the date rolls around. I go to the meeting spot, which was at this person's house. Everything's cool. They give me the keys. I go ahead, start while I'm working midway. This is just kind of like a little prequel, I guess, just to explain a little bit before. But midway, I noticed there was a vehicle next to this vehicle that I was detailing that looked like it had a bit of a crazy accident. There was a bunch of candle wax on it and stuff, and they had just asked me if I could wash that up as well. So I did that, and I did like an extra removal fee for all the wax that was stuck on it. Everything was cool. Took me a little bit extra longer. This person tipped me a little bit extra even for doing that, because it took me a little bit longer to get all the adhesive from the wax off. So it was cool. Everything seemed smooth. What had happened was, when it came to payment at the very end, their Cash App happened to not be working. That was the only app that they had as form of payment other than cash. I think they were gonna give me $350. I think the total was $325. They ended up giving me $350 for both vehicles. They only had $400 in cash. So this person gave me $400 in cash and said, hey, I wanted to give you $350 for the tip. Maybe we could just use $50 for another wash for next time. I was like, all right, cool, sounds good. Everything was cool. I was like, all right, that means they want a maintenance probably. They want another wash. So I'm like, cool, they want to continue with me. They liked the work that I did after the full detail was done when they saw it. Boom, cool. A few hours later, day goes by. It comes around to, I want to say, 7:30, 7 o'clock. I think I was cleaning out my detail vehicle because I'm actually getting a custom detail set up. It's all right now, actually. And so I don't have my vehicle, so I can't really do anything. So that night, I was cleaning out my vehicle, and I get a text. And I would pop up the actual screenshots, but for confidential purposes, like I could block out the number. I just don't even wanna show them. I'll just explain what happened. So I received a text saying something like, hey, did you happen to see a gift card in the side of the driver's side door? I was like, no, don't think so. I'm like, I put everything in the back of the trunk where I usually do. When I do full details, I start grabbing everything. As long as it's not a lot of stuff, and I'll put it in the trunk. They forgot to move jackets and stuff like that, simple stuff. So I'll put it in the trunk. So I was like, maybe I put it in the trunk, maybe go check there. And then I received a text back a little bit later saying, okay, I'll go look for it again. Thank you. And I was like, yeah, no problem. And then I also texted back saying, maybe I could check my trash for you to see if I put it in there as well. Went, checked my trash that I still had from that detail. There was nothing there. There was nothing in there. So I said, I'm sorry, I don't know what happened to it. It's not in there. So I'm like, all right, the day ends up ending. I don't get a text back for a few days. So I'm thinking, all right, he must have found it. There's no reason to contact me anymore. We're all Gucci. But I was wrong. So after the last text sent about me saying that I didn't find it in my trash or anything, I thought I was in the clear. I thought maybe, they must have found it or whatever. That's not the case. A few days later, I end up getting a text, a pretty big paragraph, something saying more of an aggressive tone, saying something like, oh, that's weird, because it was there before. And for a few months up until you just washed it. Now they're insinuating that I took it. So I'm like, bruh, are you kidding me? Like, this is the first time this has ever happened to me. I've never had this issue before. And this was kind of my thought process. I went through a few things in my head of how I should go about the situation. As many of you can probably assume, it could be pretty frustrating hearing something so absurd. When I first originally got the first text message, I was like, huh, maybe they just lost it, or misplaced it, or it fell through a crack or something like that. At first it was cool. But then the second time, a few days later, when they came back pretty much insinuating that I had to have taken it, there's no other way that it could have went somewhere else. It's easy to get out of track as a business and let your personal self get in control, and you wanna be like, F that, whatever, whatever, right? I can't let that happen, because one slip in my business is an easy screenshot and upload to Facebook, and my business is done. I've seen so many businesses around my area be posted to Facebook with situations like, oh, they broke something and didn't offer to pay for it, or they blocked me after I wanted a refund or something like that. And it just tears the businesses down, and the word of mouth gets out, and they start losing customers. And I do not want some situation like that to happen. So I remained calm, one. Two, I looked at it perspective, okay, I washed the car, and then if there truly was a gift card there and it's gone now, I see how that could look, right? So I looked at it from perspective, but then three, I remained completely professional. Through tech, I didn't, you know, say anything like, oh, you're crazy. I didn't, you know, call out or say, you know, you could have lost it, or, you know, why are you waiting till now? There's so many things in my head that I could have said that would have been not smart to say. I remained completely professional. I text apologizing that had happened, and this is exactly what I did. So at first, I didn't really know what to do. I went in a local group chat in my Facebook that I joined a few months ago, and I posted the screenshot. So I was like, you know, what should I do with this? I had a bunch of great replies, and I took, you know, the best replies, and I felt that it was most professional. Mixed them all together, and this is what I ended up coming up with. So I first thought about back to my trash can. I was like, you know, maybe I did put it in there, and maybe I had just missed it. So I repeated the question after she had, you know, insinuated that it probably was me that taking it, or, you know, whatever disappeared. I asked her, I said, was it paper or was it plastic? Because I was like, if it was plastic, most likely I had put it back in the back of the trunk where I usually leave everything else, and maybe it was just missed, or maybe it fell somewhere. So I was like, maybe that. Or I was like, if it's paper, it might have been easy to mix that up and accidentally have thrown it away. And I was like, maybe I missed it somehow. So I went back and I asked the question by saying that it was paper. It was a paper gift card to a clothing store. So I said, oh, okay. You know, I went and looked back in my trash can, and I was like, yeah, it's not there. I confirmed it. So I replied and I said, yes, I apologize. I have no idea what happened. The card is very thin and maybe could have been blown somewhere or accidentally moved or something, you know, through these past few months. I said, do you know how the gift card was purchased? If it was purchased with paper, most likely it can be connected to an email, which can be reprinted. So that was the suggestion that I had through the Facebook group, is to ask. I told them that it was paper, so they said if it was paper, most likely it could be connected to an email. So I was like, you know what, let me go ask that. Suggested it, and I was like, maybe it could be reprinted, thinking I stole it. So I'm kind of reassuring and, you know, telling her, like, if that's true, you could still reprint it and you could use it for yourself. I'm not gonna use it because I don't have it. So from here, it kind of went, you know, a little sideways. Got a little defensive and said something like, are you kidding? I'm not gonna read exactly said because I don't wanna say word for word, and, you know, I don't wanna risk anything outside of these YouTube videos to really happen with my business, but pretty much, you know, saying like, you know, are you serious? That's kind of crazy. Said something like, I had just seen it a few days ago, or right before I parked it when you did it, and I was gonna use the gift card to pay for some things at the clothing store for their kid. So I'm sorry, I'm stuttering a lot because I'm trying to be very strategic about how I'm saying the message. So I read that and I'm like, okay. I had also had a suggestion that said something about maybe offer the tip back, because it's like, in this situation, it's like, damned if I do, damned if I don't, right? It's like, if I try to offer and I'd be like, haha, I knew it, he took it, he's trying to give me money back, he feels bad. If I don't offer money, then it looks bad because I just wanted to try to steal it or whatever, you know, and then it looks bad either way. I go try to tell someone, I don't want that to happen to my business. I don't want to risk anything like that. Someone said, you know, maybe offer the tip back. So in total, technically the tip was $100, even though up until I used that $50 credit for another walk, technically I have a $100 tip. So this is what I said. Not at all was I trying to blame you. I apologize if it came off that way. I was simply stating that maybe a few things, you know, a few other suggestions that could have happened to it, like it may have flown out or something like that if it was a paper gift card. I said, if you aren't able to find it, I have no issue returning the $100 tip that you gave me. Hopefully this makes it right for you. Pretty much just leaving it at that. And then they ended up saying, I think they ended up saying, it's okay, no worries, and left it at that. I ended up coming back with that, just saying, once again, I really apologize. I didn't never said, like, I didn't insinuate, like, I didn't specifically say I would never take anything. Like, I didn't specifically say that. I just continued on being professional. Like, I apologize for the disappearance of it. I offered $100 back, pretty much doing everything to show that it wasn't me, but explaining that it wasn't me, if that makes sense. Just because, I don't know, it's like a psychological thing. It's hard for me to explain that, but I don't know, hopefully it makes sense to some of you guys. So that's pretty much how I went about it. It's been a few days. I haven't gotten any crazy bad reviews. The person still actually is on my social media and still follows me, and I noticed has been interacting with my stories, not saying anything, but still viewing them. So, you know, if it was really such a bad situation, I feel like something worse would have happened out of it. I don't know. But yeah, that's pretty much what ended up happening. Now I'm gonna just quickly tell you guys what I'm gonna do forward to prevent this from ever happening again. So that this doesn't ever happen again, I'm gonna do one, possibly two pretty simple things. One, before I go to every detail from now on, I was trying to make it a luxury to where if they did have a few things, I would separate it for them, just because if they're paying that much money, I wanna be able to clean have everything be clean. So sometimes I'll take stuff out of the console, put it in a bag, or the side doors, put it in a bag, and then put it in the back. I tried to make it a luxury before. Will it be? No more. No, I'm not doing it anymore. So from now on, simple. I usually give a 24-hour text ahead of time saying, you know, confirming our appointment. In those confirmation texts, I'm gonna say something like, hey, if you could just please take out any valuable items or, you know, anything that might get in the way or whatever that you want to be out of the way, so that way I can clean through it and that way I have no issues. So that way they're taking out all their valuables. They know what's in there. So I'm not sitting there trying to differentiate what's valuable and what's not, because it is very possible to throw, not that this is what happened in this situation, but it's very easily, like, that could have easily happened, that a paper gift card could have been thrown away. Any of us could have done that. That's super simple. To possibly sign some type of release or liability form, pretty much stating that they know what items are in there, or, you know, that I'm not responsible for any items or whatever that go missing, something like that. I'm not 100%, you know, certain with the name of that form or whatever exactly I'm gonna need for something like that. So if you guys in the comment section down below have any idea and would like to suggest or tell me the correct, you know, term names or form names or whatever, I really appreciate it. But yeah, some type of form that they sign, please let me know in the comment section below. But yeah, I might do something like that in the future to cover my butt. That is a lesson learned. I hope nothing happens out of it. If something does happen and I get a bad review somehow, I will let you guys know in these YouTube videos. But anyways, that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys watched all the way through, make sure to smash that like button, comment any video ideas you guys have down below. I got my custom setup coming. You guys will see that video soon. And subscribe. Any tools or products will be down in the description below. Thank you guys so much for supporting, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.